following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. They do great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit
That's awesome.
For a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's a TGIF, folks. Let's make it a great one. To master love, you have to practice love. The art of relationship is all mastery, and the only way to reach mastery is with practice. To master a relationship is therefore about taking action, not about attaining knowledge. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 300, NASDAQ off 104, S&P's down 33, gold contract up $18.50, trading at $13.10 an ounce. You got silver up 7 cents, $14.56 an ounce. Light sweet crude, hammered, down $3.15. $53.43 a barrel. Notes and bonds. You get the 10-year note up 10 at 22 ticks, 126.12. 30-year up a full point, plus 10 ticks at 154.10. And you get King Dollar. King Dollar gave it up, down 383 ticks, trading 97.130. The euro is trading at a price point of 111.69 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is at 108.42 to one U.S. dollar. And the pound is out here at 126 to one U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world and the world of the S&Ps. Let's take a look at them. Let's pull up these E-minis as we come into the close out here today. So you're going to see the low of the day, folks, is at 27.51. And we back this in a little. Let me see. There we go. So this is wide open for a test into the low. Because what we just had here is this. 20 minutes before I get on. 10 minutes. Yeah, 20 minutes before I get on. You get a little pop out here. But what that didn't do, that couldn't even get over the downdraft that had been created on the open, which is the 27.62. You're at 27.56. Coming into the weekend, bottom line is that you're coming into the end of the month. Beginning of the month, normally window dressing, but in this particular case, folks, they're bailing out of this market as quick as they can. The futures right now, 27.56. You know, the low that this is going after right now is the swing low that was established out here on the 8th of March, which is 27.26. That's how this baby is set up. We go take a look at the NDX 100. You have the same type of setup inside the NDX 100. What you have out here inside the NDX 100, that's breaking down. It's down 107 points. That's going after the same time frame, the 8th. The top of the 8th is 7,062. The bottom of it is 69.65. And bottom line is that you have a breakdown out here. If we take a look and we look at this on a weekly basis, what you're going to see inside the SPY is the bottom line is that, you know, you're down off this high of 294, you're 275. What's game right now is the 251 to 233. And that's bringing you back to the December 26th swing low. Gold contract caught the bid. Bottom line is that you get the gold contract. It was going against this trend line yesterday, folks. It broke the trend coming into the close. So it had broken it. It had broken with you know, pretty good price as well as volume. Today, it just blew it apart. Gold contract right now, this baby wants to run up to the highs of February. The highs of February, 1361.50. Right now, you're at 1310.90. You're up $18.50. You have 315,000 contracts that are traded. Silva's still a laggard. Bottom line, Silva needs some action here. You know, it's peaking its head up, and it's peaking its head up right into the trend line. So let's see if we're up by 7 cents. You're at $14.56. We take a look at this, and you're going to see it's just peeking its head over. So, you know, we'll see how Monday reacts. I don't expect it's going to jump this line out here today, but Monday you very well may. Notes and bonds, bottom line, they just want to keep going, man. Been quite a run. There's no two ways about that. You get the 10-year up 21.6. You're at 126.11. And what you have out here is that this little baby, if we take this, let me put this on. Let me see. T1. I'm going to put this on a generic chart because what I'll show you what the TLT has already done. The TLT is actually saying that we're actually going to go to all-time lows in yield. And the 10-year is not here yet. But so check this out. We're at 126.11. And when you look at this, what has happened is that you can go all the way back. We've been in this consolidation since November of 2016. Well, the top of this consolidation inside the 10-year is 128.03. If we go over to the, well, let's look at the 30 and see where the 30 is. US 1. Yeah. So let's look at the 30. So the 30 is at 154.11. We take this. Okay, same thing. The top of that is 159. Now watch this when you bring the TLT. The TLT has broken topside. And when I say broken topside, you've broken over everything. The TLT is saying that we can actually go to 1.38 in the 10-year. So what you have is that you're going to see that we broke the consolidation that's been in place since 2016. The top of that consolidation is 129.56. You're at 130.69. So you're talking about big numbers. And, you know, bottom line is that the market itself, you know, we had talked about you get the China tariffs, okay? Bottom line, that's going to hit the S&P 500 for sure. Come out this morning, now it's going to get weaponized and it's going to go against Mexico. Bottom line, guess what? In Mexico's case, you know, it's really wild, folks. I actually have tiles coming over from Mexico right now that I'm going to get hit with. We get tiles from a little village, handmade tiles. But bottom line, it is what it is. We'll see how this shakes out because what you also have is that you have not plenty, but Chuck Grassley, who is a powerful Republican senator, is coming out saying that he thinks this is a misuse of presidential Taft authority. Well, guess what? We'll see whether anyone is going to basically put their head up and start doing their job, because the bottom line is that the longer that you can keep getting away with things, which Trump does, the bottom line, he'll just keep going. It's not going to stop. So we'll see if he was going to go do anything about it. You know, what does happen, of course, he's from Iowa, so the bottom line is that they are getting hammered beyond belief. I was talking about yesterday, yeah, it's one thing us paying a few dollars, whether we're going to buy a shirt and all this stuff, but that's our choice. It's a whole nother deal when you're talking about the aspect of losing your job or losing orders in a huge way. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Dow's down 298. Nasdaq up 102.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
It's amazing to think that Tom O'Brien started his weekly Gold Report 17 years ago with the first issue published April 7th, 2002, when gold was trading at under $300 per ounce. Gold peaked at more than $1,900 in 2011, and after spending many years consolidating at lower prices, gold may be poised for its next big run. Tom O'Brien publishes his weekly Gold Report every Monday morning for subscribers, consisting of coverage of the XAU, HUI, GDX, the dollar, bonds, South African Rand, as well as 25 different mining equities with specific buy-sell recommendations. As of April 1st of this year, the Gold Report currently has 8 active positions with an average unrealized profit of almost 8% for each open trade. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your Gold Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. Don't let gold's next big run pass you by. Sign up today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down 308. You get the NASDAQ off 105. S&P's down 34. Well, you know, when we take a look at General Motors, so when we talk tariffs from Mexico, folks, cars, a lot of cars get made there. You can see General Motors down $1.47. This is down from $40 7 weeks ago. And what General Motors has done is that this is already into the highs of the lows of December 26th. The high of that low is $33.52. You're at $33.35. And we take this and we put this on a weekly basis. What you're going to see is that good old General Motors is that I suspect you're going to get down to this lower swing point. We'll see how it handles that lower swing point. Now, when I was just talking about the aspect of tariffs, how people get hit. Yeah, I'm going to show you something. If you happen to be watching Tiger TV, I'll show you. So you know that we build a lot of houses. You may or may not, but we do build a lot of houses. So I want to show you. This one I just finished, but this one here. This is a house in St. Pete. Everything we do is in St. Pete. When you're taking a look at this, we just finished this one. Now I just finished this. When you take a look at this, what you're going to see in the inside is that is all Mexican tile. It's handmade Mexican tile. We bring containers of them over from Mexico, and then I use them in all the different bills. But what you're going to see. Now I'm a little raindrop in the aspect of what is coming in. But bottom line, folks, is that this hits, you can see in the kitchen, those are all handmade tiles also. The bottom line is that everyone's going to get hit with this. And starts out at 5%. Well, when you're talking about 5% on thousands of dollars, it adds up tremendously because the spread in the building business, folks, isn't exactly what people actually think it is. It's a great business, but the bottom line is that you better watch what you're doing. So we'll see June 10th, bottom line, 5% gets whacked on it. But I suspect what's going to happen here is it's going to get a lot bigger than 5%, because 5% is not enough to, well, it's enough for the car companies, and it's enough for, us when the car companies go up in price and we start getting hit with it, because a TAF is a tax, okay? Bottom line, we are the ones that are paying for it, okay? That is the bottom line. So let's go take a look at the some of the higher volume equities out here. Yeah, the gap gets smoked beyond belief. They come out with numbers, bad numbers. Yeah, Marbell down $1.34. Oh, check this out. Oh, we got to go to Amazon first. This is a mind blower, folks. So Amazon, right? Now, Amazon's down $38. Breaking a swing. Yeah, this thing wants to go lower. But let me see if I can get... So what's going on is that the... this is crazy. This is hilarious. Sprint and T-Mobile, folks, okay, want to merge. The Justice Department wants them to basically set up a new carrier for competition. Well, bottom line is that Amazon, you know, yesterday I was listening to a bunch of analysts saying, well, that doesn't make any sense because, you know, there's no one out there that they could get set up. Well, guess what? Amazon is interested in a big way. And this is really wild. Amazon, famous for its appetite entering new markets, the world's largest online retailer, is interested in purchasing prepaid wireless phone service Boost Mobile from Sprint and T-Mobile. Reuters reported last night. Bottom line, folks, can you imagine T-Mobile and Sprint? That's their worst nightmare, you know, because guess what? Amazon will give it away. They'll give it away all day long. And you get one of the analysts out here, his quote is that it's bat crazy, and it's not. T-Mobile and Sprint has to do everything in their power, okay, in order not to get Amazon in that business. Amazon gets in that business, let me tell you something. it will be it'll be less expensive, that's for sure, because all they're going to want is data. That's what it's going to be all about. Let's go take a look at some of the other higher volume equities out here in this market. You have... The gap got hit. That's down $2. That's trading $18.50. You get Apple down $2.50. We got Microsoft down $2. Let's go over to Apple because Apple has been making its way to lower price in a big way. We're down from $2.15. We're at $1.75. Put this on a weekly for a second. So the high of that low is 159. We're getting there. Has more space to go, but we're getting there. We go take a look inside the Dow Industrials, the strength versus the weakness inside the Dow Industrials. I suspect everything is going to be red in the Dow. Yeah, it is. So what you have out here with Dow, the biggest point losers out here, you get Boeing putting 43 negative points, Goldman putting 31, Apple putting 19. Procter & Gamble putting 17, Verizon putting 16. Bottom line is that you get some action on the way down. We go look at the NDX 100. The strength Dollar Tree is up 3.2%. Ultra Salon is up 1.7. Oh, we got to look at Ultra Salon. Check this out. What a turnaround this is. Oh, man, this is a trip. So look at this. Look at this, folks. Ultra came out with their numbers last night, and the numbers were fine, but they sold it down. And when Tommy and I went this morning, Ulta was down at this 304. It's 334. This just turned around, went topside. Bottom line is that, look at this, it went back. Yeah, it went back where that gap was, filled that total gap at 315. Now you want to go topside once again. That's impressive, man. That's really impressive in a bad market. Taken away from the NDX 100, you have Western Digital down 5.3%. Alexa Pharmaceutical is down 5.2%. You get Align Technology down 4.6%. And American Airlines is off 3.6%. Big numbers all over the place. We take a look at the... Let's go to Walmart and see what's happening inside Walmart since Amazon's getting smoked a little. Yeah, Walmart's only down 66 cents. That is no big deal. Oh, oil. Oh, my God. Oil. The oil market. CLN9. This is a hammering. Yeah, oil's going all the way to 42 right now. Now, what you have here, we've talked about this, folks, is that oil is about a week ahead of the S&Ps. Right now, oil is at $53.11. $48 is coming at us. And just to give you an idea, we're talking about yesterday, we're at 59. We're at 53. A week ago, we're at 63. So it took off $10 in a week. That is about as heavy as you can get. If we go take a look at the XLE, you're going to see that the XLE is following right along with it. Actually, it's been leading it down somewhat. The XLE is down 97 cents, trading $58.58 a share. And yeah, this is going to be one of the first ones to also get to the highs of the lows of that December 26th level. That's where this baby's going, folks. Stay right there, folks. We'll be coming right back. And metals are moving, folks. Go check out the Gold Report at TFNN. Just go over to TFNN. Go into newsletters. Do the Gold Report for a month, 6 months, a year. They all with a 30-day money-back guarantee. Come right back, folks.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down 320, NASDAQ off 110, S&P's down 36. Well, you know, when we take a look at this gasoline contract, folks, things are going to get less expensive for us here. You get unleaded gas right now down 9 pennies. How's that? This is pretty cool. We go back 2 weeks ago, you're at 205 wholesale, you're at 176, and bottom line is that this, 175, I mean, this is game down to 152 again. So this is going to be pretty wild watching this whole thing play out. We go take a look at Phillips 66. The low for the year is 78. The high is 123. And, oh, there you go. Thanks, Peter. Appreciate it, man. Bottom line, here you go. This is, see, this, when you're hunting the market, folks, in general, right? You know, you can be good at technicals. You can be good at fundamentals. Bottom line is that you want to catch on to, like, how are these sectors moving? Because this gives you a huge heads up, man. I mean, Phillips is already down here. You know, the low of the 26th was $78.93. We're at 80.62. The high of that is 84.25. That's saying, guess what? We're coming down, and we're coming down fast and furious. And the real question is going to be, does it hold when it gets into that lower level? So we'll see how this whole thing does shake out. Let me go take a look at some of the volume out here today. Now what normally would happen is that you should have light volume from now going all the way to Labor Day, folks, because on Fridays, because of the summer. We're at 532. That's low volume inside the NYSE. If we take a look at inside the NASDAQ composite, the composite is 1.6. Now, see, the composite is a problem because that 1.6 will get to 2 billion. And the composite in general, you know, this is down from, you know, those highs of 81.76. You're at 74.59. And we take and we put this composite on a longer basis. What you are going to see is that, you know, you're down pretty good. You're starting to dig into the, you're definitely digging into the December bar. You're already dug into it. And so that brings the probability much higher that is exactly where we're going to go to that low there. And the real question is going to be, you know, I suspect the first time down, you're going to hold that low. It looks to me still that what we are in here is a much larger consolidation. It's about a 24% consolidation inside the S&P. If we bring this back, what you're going to see is that, you know, you have the high out here of that 3,000. You get the low out here of that 2,346. And, you know, we could be in here for a year, year and a half. Bottom line, if Trump puts the tariffs up to 25% in Mexico, and we get 25% out of China, you're going to see these stocks get destroyed. Because once you start doing the spreads on these, those companies are not going to be making their money at all. Okay, you know, so. This is a monster tax, folks, okay? And it's a tax that you, I, and the companies that you're working for are going to pay. So we'll see just, you know, how my take is we can see how this is shaping up right now. What is shaping up, you have the car. Let me see what Ford's doing. You get GM down there. Ford's in better shape. Ford's at $9.48. Yeah, Ford's definitely in better shape than GM. They probably have less manufacturing down in Mexico, more than likely. Yeah, mortgage rates, bottom line, folks, as one of our tigers saying there, lower mortgage rates coming. They're here right now. I was checking on mortgage rates today, right before I got on. And you'll see them a lot cheaper next week. Yeah, you're dealing right now. The official Fannie Mae Freddie Mac just went under 3.99. That's what it was at about 6 o'clock this morning, 7 o'clock this morning. Now, that rate there, by the way, okay, so that can fluctuate depending on how your credit is. What I expect you're going to see here is that you are actually going to see, you're going to see rates down at probably 3.65, 3.75. If we take a look at this 10-year note, you know, right now, so picture the 10-year before we started this morning was at 125.20, and that, hey, let me do it this way. One second, I got to do it this way because this would make more sense. 10, what I'm going to do is I'm putting the 10-year yield up. So you can kind of get this. Yeah, so. Okay, so yeah, picture this. So yesterday we closed at 2.2, and the Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac 30-year was at 3.99 this morning. You know, so that's it's about, it looks like it's running about 1.8% more than where the 10-year is, right? And now the 10-year is down another, we're 2.13. We take this, and this is screaming at that 2.01. But what has happened is this. You see this bar? This bar this week is so, it's a monster. It's 2.3 to 2.1. This can blow right by here next week, man. The more I'm looking at this, it looks to me like 1.7 maybe on the agenda next week. That would be crazy. Yes, I understand. But guess what? This is barreling into that number. When you barrel into something like that with that kind of force, whole different animal. And we know what you do have is that you have a huge amount of money out there that just basically want to get their money back. And what you're going to see is that this is where the huge managers, folks, okay, still have plenty of time to make a choice, you know? So look at this. If you're a money manager, and we go to, let me do it this way. I'm going to go like that way. What you're going to see is that we started the year off. They're still going to be up a good amount of money, man. Let me see. You'll be up a fortune. So let's picture that you're still at 2754, and we started the year off at 2443. You know, they have to make a decision. You know, do they just let it go, and then all of a sudden, you know, we're going to June, it's 6 months left. Are we talking that by the end of the year, all of a sudden you're down at the lower end of the consolidation? So those managers right now got to figure out, am I going to take some money off the table? What am I going to do? You know, because the bottom line is that the last thing that they want is hear from their clients that, hey, listen, the market was up 18%. Why didn't you take some money? You know, that's always easier said than done. We know how this shakes out. That's a tough job that they have. But when you're up that much money, and if you're a technical person, you know, that'd be saying to me, you're going down the lower end of it. What you don't know, as I said a little bit earlier, I think it's a consolidation. So by the end of the year, if you're at the top end, that's great. But if you're a fundamentalist, you're taking your money off the table. Because the bottom line is that if you're depending on a deal, okay, you're out of your mind. I mean, the best thing that you can depend on with Trump is more chaos. That's what it comes down to. That's what you're looking at right here. Dow down 2, down 350. NASDAQ down 118. S&P's down 39. Come right back.
In the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN and you'll find the Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien. Welcome back, folks. Dow is on 343. The Nasdaq's off 116. S&Ps are off 38. And the way that the E-minis, folks, handling this bottom, we're going to be lower. It's handling this bottom. We just went to that 2750, and we have volume there. So this thing doesn't want to slow down coming into the close. Let's go over and take a look at the gold contract. So gold, folks, caught the bid. What you have out here in the gold market right now is that you're trading up $19.10. You have 318,000 contracts traded. That's going to put gold up at the 1361 is game once again. If we go take a look at some of these equities, they have got wide price spread, strength behind them. Nice move. An Eco Eagle up $1.60, just took out its full consolidation, going all the way back to the April 16th number. This is going to go after the 4560. We go take a look at the Franco Nevada, which is a streamer out here. Franco Nevada up 222. This is heading towards the top of its consolidation once again. And it's going to be really intriguing to see how we come into this $78 level. Because if you blow that away with volume, guess what? You're going to be up at that $80 level. Newmont Mining. Let's do Newmont. Okay, so Newmont got together with Goldcorp. Newmont also caught a bid up $1. I like this. Newmont needs a little more volume. It only has 9.8 million, but it needs more volume. Barrick also caught the bid. Barrick has volume behind it, 15 million. You can see, come right off the lows. Yesterday, you had 9 million, 15 million. Barrick broke that down, that downtrend that it has been in since March 21st. And you can see, this is the type of breaks that you like to see, a break with conviction. And what conviction is that you get wide price spread, you get accelerated volume. In this case here, we talk about, this week, the market itself had jumped the creek. Well, you can jump the creek horizontally or vertically. And you can see what just happened here. Goldcorp jumped the, Barrick Gold jumped the creek vertically. Pretty cool move. This will be interesting too, because it's going to be the end of the month, isn't it? Yeah, so on the end of the month, this will be kind of wild watching this. That what you also have is that now what you also do is you have a rejection of lower price and you're going to have lighter volume on a monthly basis. What we had done is that we come into the month of October. Barrick had 51 million shares traded. 510 million shares traded, and we did 271. Rejected it, higher price coming at you. Let's go take a look at a few of the silver stocks because silver still needs a bid. There we go. That's what we needed, though. First Majestic AG, same setup. This is a highly volatile stock, and this is a silver stock. And this also jumped the creek in spades. Yesterday we were at 574, you're at 608. This is on its way up to that 719 area. So there's no doubt we got action out here, and I'll take a look at the GC1 on a monthly basis. So this is the continuous contract on the monthly. And, oh, that's pretty. Interesting. Thanks, Peter. Yeah, so one of the tigers is just saying, put this on a monthly basis. So watch when you see this on a monthly basis, folks. Now, this is hard to do because this is, yeah, it's a clean break. It's a clean break, and I got three. Yeah, it's a three break. It's a clean break, and that's the 1344 coming at you on the continuous, which is 1365 in the contract that we're trading. And here's going to be the real kicker, folks. What has happened since 2013, okay, is that the top of the range since 2013 inside the gold contract is approximately 1360 to 1370, okay? And what we're going to see here is this. I suspect we're going to be back up to that level. Now, if you break that level, then you get a whole different animal happening. Because if we break that level, then what you do, even on a price projection, is that you take the top of that level, which is the 1377, you take the bottom of that level, which is the 1050, and you look in and say, okay, you can add almost 300 points, and that'd be saying we're going to 1600. And it looks to me that you very well, for the amount of sideways action that we've actually had, that is very possible. That's how this thing is shaken out. What would have to happen for sure is that dollar would have to basically back down. The rates are going with us. The rates are going with us in a huge way. There's no two ways about that. Rates out here, they look to me like they want to be not only lower. When we had just brought that chart up at the first place, in the 10-year rate, you can see that the 10-year rate, bottom line, is looking to very well go to 1.3. So if we go back to those TAF issues, this is going to be a wild weekend watching this shake out. First, you had Charles Grassley, the Republican senator. Now, this just came across the tape also. The U.S. Chamber of Commerce is considering legally challenging Trump's plan to impose tariffs on all Mexican goods. Bottom line, folks, we'll see if they decide to take it to court. And that bottom line, that's unusual in the case because what does happen is that normally the Chamber of Commerce wouldn't be running against the Republicans in general. Bottom line is that, let's see, imposing tariffs on goods from Mexico is exactly the wrong move. Bradley, who is the chief policy officer and executive vice president, said in an interview, these tariffs will be paid by American families and businesses without doing a thing to solve the very real problems of the border. Instead, Congress and the president need to work together to address the serious problems at the border. This is going to turn into one monster catfight, folks, in a huge way. And the collateral damage, unfortunately, is not going to be cool. Folks that get caught in the middle of it, just as our farmers are caught in the middle of it right now, you're going to have a lot of people that have nothing to do with a lot of this losing a lot of money and a lot of heartache. That's what it seems like it's going to be shake down to be. We got to take a look at the XLU. Let's see what the XLU did, because that had backed down. Okay, so you're at 58.33. Yeah, this is interesting. So the XLU, folks, okay, this is utilities. Now, when you have bonds that, you know, go on a lower yield, this utility, they're having a hard time breaking its high. And, you know, I'm wondering if this is just an aspect that because we're coming into the summer, they have to worry about fires. Oh, I see. No, it did break the high. Okay, cool. Okay. It wasn't making too much sense to me. Okay, we did break the high. We got to 60. The last high out here, the high that you'd really be looking at would be November of 2017. That was 57.23. We got above it. Yeah, we got above 3 months ago. I see what's happening. Let me just make sure of that now. Yeah, I know what I was looking at then. I was looking at Southern. So if we pull up Southern, let's see what they did. Yeah, maybe they did too. Yeah, they're the ones that are having a tough time. They're having a tough time staying above 54, 64. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. And as I come over to TFNN, folks, you want to check out the Gold Report, you just go into newsletters. You're going to see the Gold Report right there. You just hit View. You can hit Subscribe. You can get it for 1 month for $85, 6 months for $395, which is a savings of $115, a year for $695, which is a savings of $325. And what we will do, folks, I'll keep you attuned to this volume as we come to the close. And don't forget, when the program ends, I always do a 4 o'clock update, news update. So that's when I actually will have a better grip on the volume, because if we do get a dumping into the close out here, it will be on the close, meaning right at 4 o'clock. Right now, we're at 604 million inside the NYSE, and the composite is going to have the volume. We're already at 1.8. The composite will bang in with about 2.2. So I suspect we are going to have that. What we're going to be looking for is there another portfolio that is going to get pushed out? We had that happen on Tuesday when those monster numbers came in at the close, and that was the whatever portfolio got out, they must be elated right now. You can see this inside the Tiger TV. 1.4 billion was done on the NYSE. And then if we take a look at the NASDAQ at the composite, you're going to see it was 2.3 billion. But you can see that the composite itself, they've been selling this NASDAQ every single day. We did 2.3 Tuesday, 2.2 Wednesday. You know, so you're talking about very large numbers out here. What I do expect we're going to see out here is King Dollar is going to continue lower, bottom line gold higher, Silver, we need a bid on. That's the bottom line. For silver, we need a bid on. If we go over to the XAU, the HUI, they both broke their downtrend with conviction. XAU up $2.48, $69.93. And if we go over to the gold contract, what you have there, that's up $6.73 at $157.29. Now, what's really cool, folks, is that when you actually look at the sectors here, bottom line is that the only thing out here one of the only things out here that you do have that's in the green is that metal sector. So that'll bring more buying in even from the funds, particularly because we're in window dressing. 4 o'clock already. Have a great weekend, folks. Have a safe weekend. Look forward to speaking to you right back here Monday morning, 9 o'clock. Go get them, folks.